Hi, I'm George Pearson, and we'll be doing this fast Photoshop Elements background zoom effect. Real easy to do. Now I'm doing this one in Photoshop Elements 2018, but this will work in any version of Photoshop Elements. It's actually using a very old filter, and easy to do, and gives a very interesting effect. Now if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, and of course, share. Don't forget to subscribe. I do several videos every single week. And also, take a look at my complete training course. There's a link for that right there at the top of the description. Okay, let's get to it. As I mentioned at the beginning, this is a very fast, very easy, but very interesting effect that works with all kinds of portrait style images. Here's one, and here's another one. Same exact technique on both of these two images. Okay, let's see how this is done. I'm just going to delete these two layers up here and get this back to its beginning setting. There we are, there's our original photograph. Now make a copy of your background layer. Just right click, it should most likely say background. Right click and duplicate layer. There we go. I'll just hide that one, we don't need that any longer. So here is our working layer. I made a copy of this because we'll be messing this layer up. In case I make a mistake, I can always go back to my original layer and then work from there. Okay, here is the copy of our layer. We're going to now make a selection around our portrait and then use that to make a new layer with a layer mask. So I'll just grab the lasso tool and I'll make a nice, reasonably tight lasso here. You don't need to touch your figure. Just get in relatively close. Kind of like that. You can be outside for the bottom down there. That's okay. And again, just move clear around the sides here. There we go. And then take a clip around the top and back up to meet with your beginning position right there. Now come down to your options down below and make sure you set out subtract. And then come in here and just do just a little selection inside of the space between this arm and the figure and the space in here between this arm and the figure. It's a little spot just right in there. Okay, now that that is all done and I have my feathering here set at 1 pixel, just click on Refine Edge. Brings up your Refine Edge tool. And then just come in here and refine the edge. Now just do little short strokes. Now if you are using an older version of Photoshop Elements that doesn't have the Refine Edge tool, just do a real nice tight manual selection. I probably use the polygonal lasso tool for that. We can clean things up that don't fit exactly or aren't exactly perfect in here once we get this basic selection done. And just work clear around the whole figure here, just doing this little strokes. That allows Elements to think about fixing that edge without having to think too much. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now in this one, you may want to increase your contrast just a bit. This occasionally will help clean your edges up a bit in there. You can check how the edges look by coming down here to the view mode. And take a look at this on black. Looks pretty good. We're missing some spots right here and down here and a little bit up there. Let me see if I can clean that up at all. Okay, we'll have to do that manually up there. Let's try down here. Okay, that one's fixed. Had to fix those manually inside the arm and that one and that bit as well. Okay, just a few little touch-ups to work on. Back to the overlay mode. And then come down here where it says Output 2 and set this at New Layer with Layer Mask and choose OK. And that gives you that. It's a brand new layer with a nice clear layer mask so we have the clear area in the background. That's because we'll be doing our zoom effect on this layer here, which will be the background. Okay, see if we can clean this up just a bit. It doesn't need to be perfect on this one, but a bit better than this, I think, would be good. I'll just zoom in here. When you're working with the layer mask, make sure you're on the layer mask side. Just click on that side, look for the light blue outline, and you're on that side. Black hides, white shows, so let's grab our paintbrush. We have our black brush right here. Fairly small brush, I have set up a soft brush here at 20 pixels. And then just come in here and paint in. Now we can bring the opacity up maybe about 75% so it doesn't get full opacity right away. You can work in a little bit. And then just come around and clean the edges up. Remember, you don't have to go clear to the figure on this. It doesn't need to be perfect. We're going to be going out to a blurry background anyway, so anything out here that's really missing is just going to blend into that background, so that's okay. You can hold the space bar down to move the picture around and check your edges. Those are all fine. Let me just catch that little bit right there. And there's that bit right in here we need to fix. There we go. And right down in there. And then there's that spot up there next to her arm. We'll get that as well. Now this is a fairly tight edge, so I'll grab the polygonal lasso tool. It's this one right down here. And then just do a nice careful selection right around this area in here. Just working right along that edge. Now at this tool, don't go too fast or it's going to collapse your selection. You'll have to start over again. So just take your time with this. And what you're doing is you're clicking where you want to place a dot or a point, and then Photoshop Elements connects the dots. It's that easy to use. It just takes a little bit of patience to make it work out properly. If you're zoomed in like this, you get a better effect as well, a better job. Okay, almost back to the beginning actually. This is going pretty fast in here. A few little strange wrinkles like that to get around. And then back up again, up towards the top. And back where I started right there. Now that I have that selection made, I can then come in with the paintbrush and then just paint black on the layer mask right inside that area so that it becomes transparent. There we go. Okay, and then just deselect that. Let's move over to the other side. Get a little bit more right in there. There we go. And do the same thing right down here. It's a little bit right here I think we can clean up as well. It's not that critical. Okay, so right inside here, same exact trick. The polygonal lasso tool, and then just come around and put in dots, and then elements connects those dots, and that makes the selection. Whenever you're using this tool, just take your time and it'll work out very nice. This actually is usually my favorite tool to use when making a selection because it is so accurate. It just, again, is a little bit of a time-intensive tool because you had to be putting all these real small dots. We can be very, very accurate and clean with this tool. Okay, back to the starting point right there. Same thing, back to the paintbrush. Just paint black on the layer mask, and that hides that area. And then deselect, and we'll go back to fit on screen. Now you can use any technique you want, actually, to make your layer mask whatever you like, whatever is most convenient for you. Okay, that's the hard part. Hard part's done. Let's now bring back in our background copy right here. Make sure you're on that layer. And we'll now put the zoom effect on here. This is one of the oldest effects in Photoshop Elements, also one of the oldest effects inside of Photoshop as well. It's under the blur setting on filters, and it's the radial blur. Normally this will give you a spin effect like that, and you can control how much spin you're using. But it also has this zoom effect right there, blur method zoom. I normally leave my quality here at good. It seems to work out just fine. Now set it at zoom, pull the amount clear to the top, all the way to 100 over here, and then notice that you can grab the icon here, actually this little thumbnail, and you can move around the focus point. Now it's not exact, but you can look at your picture and figure out about where your center is. She's about centered horizontally, and she's maybe 2/5 in there, so let's see if I put this right about here. That should be pretty much right behind her figure on the zoom. But right around in here somewhere. That's all set. Choose OK. It then does that zoom for you right there. As you can see, it's a real easy technique, but it's a real nice, clean effect to it. So there you go. That's how you do this zoomed background effect. Again, the only real hard part is doing the initial layer with the layer mask, getting a nice clean layer with your layer mask. Once that's done, the rest of it just goes super fast. Don't forget to check out my complete training course for Photoshop Elements, and there's a link for that right down at the top of the description. In my YouTube videos, I cover a lot of stuff, but I really just scratch the surface on what you can do with Photoshop Elements. I cover everything in my training. So if you really want to learn Photoshop Elements, that's the best way to do it. And don't forget to click on the like button and share, and also subscribe so you won't miss out on any videos in the future.